Guys, this is 2017 question paper for 14 marks. Guys, if you read this question, 14 marks for 2017, Miss Vimala had two houses. How many houses? Two houses. First point, the first house was occupied by herself for residential purpose. So, in the house she is staying, in the first house, she got this house from her brother as a gift on 15th of August 1999. See guys, 15th of August 1999. 15th of August 1999, which is before 2001, where we don't have cost of inflation index. So, we should ignore whatever the cost of acquisition given for 1999. Her brother purchased this house for in the year 1988. So, the value of the house in 1988 was how much? 35,000. But the fair market value as on 1/4/2001 is 70,000 rupees. Now, which one will you take? Whichever is higher only we will take. Right? Whichever is higher. Which is higher? 70,000 rupees is higher. So, we take cost of acquisition as 70,000 only because the asset is purchased before 2001 and 2. Any asset which is purchased before 2001 and 2, we ignore that or else we take that with the fair market value as on 1/4/2001 as 70,000 rupees. So, the higher value is 70,000. Yeah. Vimala spent 6,500 on its improvement on 10th of September 2010. See, 2010 is after 2001 and 2. So, therefore, this improvement also will come. She sold it on 30th of September 2018. See, 30th of September 2018 is nothing but our previous year 1819 income for 18,50,000 rupees. She purchased another house for her residential purpose on 25th of March 2019 for 9 lakh rupees. We can take it and I will explain to you what exactly this is. See, this is a first one. See, first we should identify whether it is a short term or a long term. This is a long term capital asset because 1988 to 2018-19 is a long term. She got it in 1989. From 99 to till 1890 she is keeping it almost all 20-30 years. So it is a long term capital asset. Okay guys, now let us see here. Next point, she had purchased the second house for 56,000 in 2006 and 2007. So 2006-07 CII will be available for us and had let out for residential purpose. She sold this house on 31st of August 2018 for 8,50,000 by incurring the selling expenses of 47,800. Even this is also long term because she purchased in 2006-07 and sold it in 1819. So, thereby it is also long term capital asset. So, first and second both are long terms. Next is she had purchased jewellery in 2007-08 for rupees 75,000 and on 25th of February 2019 she sold this jewellery for 8,50,000 rupees and purchased a new jewelry for 2 lakh rupees. So, again this is also a long term capital asset because jewelry was purchased in 2007-18 which is sold in the year 2018-19, so which is almost 10 years, so we can take it as a long term. Motor car sold on 1st of December 2018 for 90,000 rupees was purchased by her in January 2018. 8 for rupees 1,40,000 and its written down value on 1/4/2018 is 76,000. Car is used in business. So this is considered as a short term capital asset. Why? I told you, car, plant, machinery, furniture, equipment, motor vehicles, computers, if it is used in the business, if these assets are used in the business, these are the depreciable assets. So, for depreciable assets, we take written down value, but not the cost of acquisition value. So, therefore, this is the only item which comes in the short term, and I will show you how to solve this question. Now, let us take the rules. Computation of long-term capital gain. Long-term capital gain. First, we'll take a first house. Sale proceeds or sale price. First house was sold for 18,50,000 rupees. 18,50,000 rupees. And there is no selling expenses. So therefore, I am taking it as a indexed cost of acquisition. Indexed cost of acquisition. So what is the cost of the asset in the 88 was 35,000 and fair market value as on 1/4/2001 and 2 is 70,000. So therefore, I'll write 70,000, whichever is the higher value, only will be taken, divided by 100 into 280, because this is the inflation index. Cost of inflation index for 2001-2 is 100. And which is sold in the year 1819, and CII is 280, and let us know how much we get. 70,000 divided by 100 into 280, we get 1,96,000 rupees. 1,96,000 rupees. Now, 5,600. This is called as long-term capital gain. But what she has done here is, she sold her first house and she spent on improvement also, right? We'll do it, okay? 1,96,000. 1,96,000. She spent for improvement also. We calculate indexed cost of improvement. See, she improved this house by spending 6,500 in the year 2010. So, 6,500 rupees she spent in the year 2010 and 11. CII is given in the question at the end as 167, and we have to find out what is the index cost of improvement. 6,500 divided by 167 into 280 is 10,898. Now, this is the total car index cost of the first house. It comes to 2,06,898. 2,01,34,16,43,103. This is long-term capital gain of first house. What happened is, she sold the first house and purchased another residential house for 9 lakh rupees. See, we have a section called exemption under section 54. Exemption under section 54. What is this exemption under section 54 says? See, section 54 says If an individual sells any old residential house property, see, selling old residential house property, if you sell old residential house property, from the sale proceeds of the old residential house property, if you purchase new residential house property before 1 year or after 1 year from the date of sale, see, it's very simple here. If you sell a old residential house property and purchase a new residential house property before 1 year from the date of sale or after the date of sale, after 1 year from the date of sale. See, what is our previous year is 2018 and 19. If you purchase in the year 2017-18, this is called as before. If you purchase a new residential house property in the year 1920 after 1 year, this is considered as 1 year. Means you should purchase a new residential house property only, not a commercial house property or a commercial building. You should sell old residential house property and purchase a new residential house property, then only you will get this deduction. Okay, this is the first point we have to write for exemption under section 54. What happens, sir? I don't want to purchase a constructed ready-made house. I want to construct my own house property. So for construction purpose, within 3 years you have to construct. Within 3 years construction should be completed. So if you sell old residential house property and construct a new residential house property within 3 years, then the exemption under section 54 will be eligible for. See, if you purchase or construct a new residential house property, a new residential house property should be hold. That means the individual should hold at least for 3 years from the date of purchase of the new residential house property. Because if you purchase this within 1 year from the date of sale, in the very next year if he sells, then you will get the exemption also, and you will get a capital gain for the new residential house property also. So it's not the condition here. Yeah? You should hold a new residential house property for 3 years. Once if you purchase a new house, you should keep it for 3 years. After 3 years, if you want to sell, you can sell. Got it? So this is about exemption under section 54. Now, how much exemption you will get? See, you will get exemption. I will write it here. Exemption under section 54 is cost of new residential house property. What is the cost of new residential house property? Is 9 lakhs or long term capital gain. What is the long term capital gain? Is 16,43,102. In these two, whichever is lower, which is lower in this, whichever is lower or whichever is less, 9 lakhs is less. So therefore, I will deduct 9 lakh rupees here and take it as so 7,43,102 rupees as a what? Taxable long term capital gain for house number 1. I hope all of you understood what is exemption under section 54F. If you sell old residential house property and buy a new residential house property within 1 year from or before 1 year from the date of sale, or construct the new residential house property within 3 years, and exemption you will get is what is the cost of new residential house or long term capital gain, whichever is lower will be given as a deduction under section 54. I hope all of you understood. Now let us see the second house. Second house sale proceeds is ₹8,50,000, but she paid certain expenses for this, selling expenses, she paid was ₹47,800,200,208. This is called net sale price. What is this? Net sale price. From this we have to deduct indexed cost of acquisition. What is the cost of acquisition is ₹56,000, which she purchased in the year 2006 and 2007. And for 2006-07, in the question itself, it's given CII is 122. What is for 280 cost of inflation for 89? Now, if you calculate this, 56,000 divided by 122 into 280 is 1,28,525. Now we'll take 673,675. This is the long term capital gain number 2. This is the long term capital gain number 1. Now let us continue this problem in this case. All of you understood 54F, right? Under section 54. Now let's see the third one. She purchased a jewelry in 2007-08 for 75,000 and sold the same jewelry on 25th of February 19 for 8,50,000. Now third one is sale of jewelry, 8,50,000. Since there is no expenses, directly we go for indexed cost of acquisition. Okay, what is the purchase price of the jewelry was 75,000, which was purchased in 2007 and 8, and 129 CII into 280. Now let us see how much we get. 75,000 divided by 129 into 280 is 1,62,791. Now we get 90,278,6. This is long term capital gain number 3. Now if you take the total long term capital gain, because motor car is a short term capital asset, first we have to compute the long term capital gain, then we have to compute the short term capital gain. So 6,87,209 plus 6,73,675 and 7,43,109, and which comes to 21,03,986. This is taxable long term capital gain. See, we have 1, 2, and 3. 1, 3 numbers, if you add, you will get 21,03,000. How much? 986. This is the long term capital gain. Now let us see long short term computation of short term capital gain. So for this we have sale proceeds of car used in the business. Used in business. For how much we sold it? We sold it for 90,000 rupees. And what is the written down value of the car as on 1/4/2018? Was 76,000. And your short term capital gain is 14,000. This is short term capital gain, which is taxable. Now the total capital gain, total capital gain is 21,03,986 plus 14,000 short term capital gain. So this is the total long term, total capital gains. All of you understood?
So this is a question which was asked for 2017 for 14 marks.
Guys, you should understand section 54 is very, very important. Exemption under section 54 in this question, you will get 4 marks only for this exemption under section 54. If you don't show this, then your long term capital gain will also go wrong and total capital gain also will go wrong. Okay? Hope you all of you understood. Just copy it. Okay? Thank you.